first of all, it's a great pleasure to be here and to do this statue of this great, iconic person known around the world, I suppose. It was commissioned by the university through the generousness of Chris Laporte. I understand a number of things here named after him. He lives in Houston. He's an ex of this university. Great guy, collector of my art otherwise. And so that's how the connection is. That's why what I'm doing, why I was chosen to do this statue.
You've done, I've seen your work, and you've done a lot of political figures and presidents. Was this your first sports figure?
Yes, it is. First sports figure. Yeah, I think it is. Recently, I just finished one about that same size of Charlie Wilson. Anybody know who he was? Charlie Wilson's war? Mm-hmm. He was a crazy guy, a Texas congressman that went first to Afghanistan, brought the shoulder-fired missiles that brought the Russian helicopters down. So he's honored by a big statue like that. But I've done all the U.S. presidents, big busts that are.
What were some of the unique challenges about this particular piece? Just in doing this one, obviously you've done lots of sculptures like this, but was there anything unique about this one in terms of the challenges?
Well, I just want to get the right pose for her and the right attitude in her expression. And I have her leaning back. Of course, she always had her arms crossed like that. I mean, this hardly an exception of whatever you see ever. And she's leaning back. Her right heel is in the air slightly, feet are apart like that. So it's a pose of, I would say, triumph. Of it's not a sad thing at all, I have to tell you that. It's she looked like she won.
Pat's known for her eyes and her stare. Were the eyes hard to get?
No, not particularly. No. Well, Donna Thomas came down there to see the clay model and criticized it, give a critique of it, criticizing the wrong word, saying you made it a little bit. So I worked on her face there while Donna was watching that. She signed off on it and said, that's it. So.
Are there other things when you're trying to capture somebody like this, are there other things you look at, photos, video, or?
Yeah, right. In her case, I looked at lots of videos, lots of photographs, and made blow-up photographs, also the life size, I mean, bigger this size, and everything to them. Yeah, the success of a sculpture depends on the amount of data that you got.
Mm-hmm. But you're not trying to recreate a particular scene or something like this when you're doing a sculpture. You're just, you looked at multiple pictures, multiple videos, and then kind of did your own creation in that regard.
Yeah. Well, the commission was a single figure standing there. One of the things I would like to have done is I saw photographs of her jumping and everything. That would have made a more interesting sculpture in terms of just plain design.
Uh-huh.
But that's not what we wanted. We wanted something like this.
Okay. Have you gotten a chance to meet Pat yet?
Sorry?
Have you gotten a chance to meet Pat yet?
On television. whatever it's called, you can talk to somebody on television.
And
so when they were in Houston, they rang her up, and she could see it, the model of it, and she could see me, and I could see her, and we just said hello, and that sort of thing. I've never met her.
You'll get to meet her tomorrow. Is it neat?
I'm not going
to
be here
tomorrow. Oh, bummer.
I was hoping I could meet her this morning somehow and return this.
So did you want to see her to model the statue after her? Would that have helped to see her in person to do it? Or are pictures better at designing something?
Well, as I said, it's the quality of the data you got. If you meet her in person, obviously you can see things that the photograph can't give you. But if you meet a person in person and you take your own photographs, then you know exactly what you need. All the rest of them are just shots of her in every possible, always from the front usually, and very few from the back. So I had to pretty much guess what the back of her head looked like. And
so how long did the process take from start to finish to get this complete? Was it a long time?
How long did it take?
Yeah.
About 3 months, start to finish, 3 to 4 months. My part of it was just doing the clay model, life size like that, and giving it to the foundry. And the foundry goes through a long process called the lost wax process. It's kind of complicated to finally get at the final thing. And I go back at the end, that was just last week, to witness the putting on the patina of her, on her. And that's, they heat it up very hot and then paint on acid, and the acid gives a permanent color to the bronze. And then they whack, I mean, scrub it and do it, and put on a final coat that's called Incrolac. It's kind of a varnish, a final varnish, which will last for several years.
How tall is that statue? What's the exact height of the statue that you did?
8'7", I think it is.
8'7".
Yeah, almost 9 feet.
And did they commit, when it was commissioned, did they say they wanted it a certain size, or did you make it that?
Oh, we had to go back and forth on that. They wanted a life size. And I had to convince them that, in my experience, a life size statue seen from afar looks diminished.
Right.
In an interior, life size is okay. But when it's outside, it's got to be big. And normally, 120% or 150% is about where it should be. I think she's 144% of real height or something.
Would you have liked to have done one even bigger, given now that you see
what's at? No, I wanted to do, well, the size should be determined by the site where it's going to go. And of course, I wasn't here, but understanding with all the drawings what the plaza would look like, I figured that was about right.
What's the weight?
A 500 pounds.
How do you get it here from Houston?
On a flatbed. Oh, we flew. Carry-on luggage. Put it under the seat.
Figured.
She came on a big flatbed truck last night.
From Houston.
The direction at 10 o'clock last night.
From Houston.
Pardon? From Houston, yeah. Two-day trip. And then they left this morning. Driving on back.
How physically exhausting is it to make the first sculpture, like the wax model, I guess, or the clay model that you made?
Physically exhausting? It's not physically exhausting, not like anything else. Well, you have to have a ladder and climb up on stuff, but I mean, it's not.
So at 86, 87 years old, it's not.
86, I'm not 86.
So are you happy with how it turned out?
This one? Oh yeah. I think everybody will be when they see it.
What do you want people to take away when they see the statue, especially Pat? What would you? Do you have something in mind what you want people
to? Well, I want it to look like a successful person, a successful life, a successful winning a ball game, content. You know, she's leaning back, and I'm supposed to not describe the expression too much. We're supposed to be a surprise. But you'll see it. She looks like a winner. That, if there's one word I would use, it would be that. She looks like a winner.
You see?
Since she couldn't come, I asked for Donna Thomas, who brought this shoe down. I said, just give me one of her shoes, and this is her right shoe. And because in the videos, there were various heels and styles of shoes, and I wanted to get one that would work for this, and so this is it. And so I'm bringing it back. Give it back to her.
So you just used the measurements in the shoes? Is that what you used it for? So you just used it for measurements? Is that what you used it for?
For the measurements and the style.
And so those are the shoes the statue's wearing?
She's 1.44 times this in every dimension. And the style and the folds across here and the height of the heel. Mine's not this famous. This is alligator. And that's bronze. But anyhow, to get the style.
So where does the Pat Summitt sculpture rank in the list of the sculptures that you've made?
How does it range?
Rank.
Well, I can't rank it. I can't do that. People, which of your paintings do you like the most? I usually say the most recent. But then I'll change when I do another one. So I'm pleased with it. I think everybody will be, and that's the main thing.